Doctor Who. Unlucky 13 Part 3 by David T. Loamx. Almost goners. One Mondasian Cyberman put its hand out on Elizabeth Snowden, then just in time Captain Jack's vortex manipulator functions at last. The unit team vortex jumps into the next room with a bubble of light around them. The team are not safe yet. Save but not for long. Elizabeth Snowden screams again. Captain Jack, why did you scream for? Elizabeth Snowden, a Cyberman hand was on me, must got cut off in the vortex jump. They still have Cybermen to contend with in this Matrix pod room, but it's so different to the one there were in. There is a Cyberman logo on the wall underneath the sign. It has CR2, Cybermen Room 2, followed by CF10, Cybermen Floor 10, but the unit team wouldn't have noticed it beforehand. The unit have Nightmare and Silver Cybermen trouble, but they can take these ones down with the gold bullets they have left. Alex King and Elizabeth Snowden take them out. Elizabeth misses one of the Cybermen and ends up shooting the Matrix pod's computer mainframe, causing the Matrix to glitch. She aims at the Cyberman she intended to shoot at in the first place, killing it stone dead. Alex King on the other side the Matrix pod room takes out the last Cyberman down. Kate Stewart then runs to the computer of the Matrix mainframe for that room. Kate Stewart finds out if she can open the Matrix pods from there, that if she can find the Doctor. The Matrix pod doors are all locked and can't be opened unless she can hack in somehow. To find the Doctor, she has to be careful not to open the ones with Cybermen in. The aim to find the Doctor. Kate Stewart, the computer's mainframe is glitching. It will be hard to find which one has the Doctor in the pods. That if he is here in this room. Alex King, how do we know which pod the Doctor is held in? How do we know there be no Cybermen in them? Captain Jack, I am not sure, it be hard to see in these ones, they all different colors. It is hard to pinpoint it on my vortex manipulator, now it is pointing at this one on the second row of the pods. Odds. Elizabeth Snowden, can you open it and find out? Captain Jack, tries to open the Matrix pod in front of him, doesn't look like we can just open it from here. Kate, can you see if you can open them from the computers, please? Kate Stewart, I will try, but it is glitching, it will be hard to do. The unit team and the finding of the Master. As Kate Stewart tries to find if she can at least open one of the pods, even though the computer's mainframe is glitching, she hacks into opening one of them. She ends up finding that the Master is in the red pod, one that Captain Jack is at. Alex King, wait, isn't that the Prime Minister that went missing and killed the President of the United States? Captain Jack, yes, but he is not what you think he is. Elizabeth Snowden, then who is he then? Captain Jack, he is the Master. Alex King, wait, I read about the Master in our unit files, why didn't we know about him being the Prime Minister? Captain Jack, that's because you all tricked into thinking he was human and a real person, and born back on Earth. Elizabeth Snowden, but how is that possible? Captain Jack, remember the Archangel program for phones? Elizabeth Snowden, yes, I remember, didn't that get discontinued years ago? Captain Jack, yes, it did, but he used it to tap in your minds and hypnotized people to vote for him. He even faked his bio as Harold Saxon, which he never existed. Alex King, so, all this time in all our faces the PM is the Master, how come we never worked that out before? Captain Jack, that how the Archangel program worked, it's like you know something is wrong, but you can't quite look back at it, it's like it's blocking you from looking. In the old Torchwood we chipped at what we called the wall. Once you break through you get to the truth. One of our Torchwood members died trying to get to the truth by going to the source itself. Alex King, shouldn't we wake him? Captain Jack, why should we? He killed a lot of people the last time we met. Alex King, that is as maybe, but maybe he knows where the Doctor is, we could use him. Captain Jack, no, having him awake could be dangerous. Kate Stewart, never mind the Master. I think I found him, I found the Doctor, but I only just got bypassed the glitching. Elizabeth Snowden, so which pod is he in? Kate Stewart, would you believe he is in the blue pod, behind Captain Jack and Alex there? Captain Jack and Alex King look behind them and look at each other in disbelief. Alex King turns to Kate Stewart and says, "You are joking, Mom?" Elizabeth Snowden, walks up to where Kate Stewart is at the computer mainframe is, "Can you open it up and see?" Kate Stewart and Elizabeth Snowden look at the computer and sees two hearts beats from the doctor. Elizabeth Snowden, "No wonder Captain Jack's vortex manipulator got confused, there were two time lords in same the room." Kate Stewart, "I got it." The blue matrix pod opens and mist is flowing out of it, and they see an old man standing there. Alex King, "That isn't the doctor." Captain Jack, "Oh no, that is the doctor all right." Elizabeth Snowden, "What you mean that's the doctor?" Kate Stewart, "It is him. Captain Jack is right, but this is earlier version of him. In fact, I think that is the original him." The first doctor wakes up from out of the matrix pod he was in and walks out of the matrix pod. The first doctor sees Captain Jack and Alex standing there. The first doctor walks to Alex and says, "Oh, my young man, could you tell me what is going on? I am the doctor, by the way, and what I am doing here, huh?" Alex King, in shock, "Doc, Tor who?" The first doctor, "So, you boys are going to be diddle-daddling around or going to tell me where I am, and where is Ben and Polly?" Captain Jack, "Well, I am Captain Jack, this is Alex King, the ladies at the Matrix computer, over there are Kate Stewart and Elizabeth Snowden." Elizabeth Snowden, "Who is Ben and Polly?" The first doctor, "They are the people I travel with, I must have lost them somehow, hum." Kate Stewart, "That's funny, my lieutenant officer is named Ben Polly." Alex King, "Wait, hold on, if this is the first and the original doctor, and if he is here that means he is out of his own timeline, then wouldn't that be a paradox?" The first doctor, "What you mean out of my timeline, hum?" Alex King, "When we were trying to look for the doctor, we thought we getting the doctor we know our version of him, we then ended up with you. Anyone getting a headache?" Question of the first regeneration. The first doctor, "Ah, you mean me from the future, it's so nice I have a future." The first doctor feels faint, "This body of mine is wearing a bit thin." Kate Stewart looks at the information on the first doctor on the computer's mainframe. "Oh no, whoever brought the doctor out of his timeline, he must not have regenerated yet." The first doctor almost falls to the floor, but Captain Jack and Alex King catches the doctor before falling down. Alex King, "Doctor, are you okay?" The first doctor looks at his hand and sees the golden glow in his hand. "I be fine, my dear boy." Elizabeth Snowden walks to the first doctor. "So you're what the doctor looked like originally?" The first doctor, "Yes, my dear child, I am the original, you might say." Elizabeth Snowden, "Are you not scared of regeneration?" The first doctor, "Of course, I am scared, I have never regenerated before. I mean, what will I look like? What will I sound like? I have seen my friends regenerate before, and it's frightening seeing it for yourself." Elizabeth Snowden, "What you mean, doctor?" The first doctor, "They always look different, same memories of who they are, but their personalities change, even their taste buds change, having to find out what you like all over again. The process of it seems so scary to me, I really don't want to go and end up going through that." "Now then, tell me, how did you end up being here with these people you seem to be working with?" Elizabeth Snowden, "You mean unit?" The first doctor, "Yes." Elizabeth Snowden, "Yes, well, part from Captain Jack there, he works at Torchwood, but both teams work with alien happenings sometimes." The first doctor, "Oh, I see, I ask as I never heard of your teams before." Kate Stewart, "That is because we never worked with you, well, not yet anyway, you know timelines, doctor?" The first doctor, "Ah." Yes, you can only tell so much, not to mess with the future timelines. Kate Stewart, pretty much, Doctor, do you think you could help me find your version of you, well, your future self, so to speak? The First Doctor, I can do what I can, would you two men help me up, please? Captain Jack and Alex King help the First Doctor up, thank you both, how kind of you, The First Doctor walks over to the Matrix computer mainframe to where Kate Stewart is at, so, then what seems to be the problem you are having, my dear, Kate Stewart, well, you see, my dear, what? Never mind. Well, you see, I'm trying to find our version of you, well, future you on this computer here, but it's glitching all the time. The First Doctor, when did this computer start glitching exactly? Kate Stewart, it started when Elizabeth here shot at it. Elizabeth Snowden, not my fault. I tried to shoot at that Cyberman earlier, and I missed, well, you can see that it has hit the computer's board. The First Doctor, Cybermen. You have met them too. Alex King, yes, we have the body remains over there, Doctor. Captain Jack, the Cybermen have always scared me, well, way more than Daleks. The First Doctor, you know about Daleks too, oh my dear, dear, I guess my future doesn't change that much then, Anyway, let's find a way to find myself then and fix the glitching somehow, what you think, Kate Stewart, yes, if we can both fix the computer's mainframe, we can find our doctor. But how is the question? The First Doctor, have you ever tried looking at the computer's backboard panel, you thought of checking the wiring? Kate Stewart, no, I never thought of that. Why didn't I think of that? The First Doctor, that because, my dear, you were too busy trying to work out that computer in a way to find me in the future. The problem solving. The First Doctor see at the bottom the computer's panel and takes it off. The First Doctor sees that the wiring for the computer is frazzled a bit. The First Doctor, Yes, I see the problem, the wiring looks frazzled. They could be fixed with new wiring. Elizabeth Snowden, there must be tools around here to fix the wiring with. Alex King, who are you, MacGyver? Elizabeth Snowden, oh, very funny. The First Doctor, I am sorry, MacGyver? Alex King, it's a TV show about a secret agent, who doesn't carry a gun with him and tries fixing things with a Swiss Army knife, a kettle, and a string, and makes bombs, if need be, the show sounds like some else we know. The First Doctor, really, Oh, you mean me. Only I don't carry a Swiss Army knife, although that'd be handy right now. Elizabeth Snowden, what about your sonic screwdriver? The First Doctor, sonic what now? Captain Jack, never mind, Doctor. Is there other way to fix it? It's not like there's spare wiring lying around. Kate Stewart, wait a minute, yes there is. The Cybermen, they have some wiring in their bodies, we should use them to fix the glitching on this computer. Captain Jack, that's right, but how are we going to fix the wiring with there no tools around here? Elizabeth Snowden, here, borrow my Swiss Army knife from my bag, Doctor. Alex King, oh my, really? Captain Jack, Alex, if you can help move the Cybermen remains over there, where the doctor is, it'd be easier to get the wiring out of them to pass to the doctor. Alex King helps Captain Jack to move the remains of the Cybermen to over where the First Doctor is at the Matrix computer mainframe. So, they can use the wiring to fix the computer. The First Doctor looks at the Cybermen, my word, they don't look like the Cybermen I have seen. How strange, anyhow, Kate, can you switch the computer off, then we can fix the wiring. Kate Stewart, yes, of course I can, if I find where to shut it down, never mind, I have found where I can shut it down. The First Doctor, good, now Elizabeth, can you help me cut some wiring of the Cybermen, and why you looking at me like that? Elizabeth Snowden, well, it's when you said the Cybermen they look different, what did you mean by that? The First Doctor, you do ask a lot of questions, don't you? Elizabeth Snowden, well, questions is my kind of thing to ask, you going to answer my question? The First Doctor, yes, of course, well, the Cybermen I have seen don't look like them once I have seen look almost human-like, apart from the robotic voice, and you don't see their faces, they are very strong. When I first encounter them, they said they are from a twin planet of Earth, but their world got drifted into space long ago. Their planet is dying, plus they want us become like them, with no emotions or anything like that. The people of Mondas were like you and me once until they started dying. Elizabeth Snowden, while helping Elizabeth is helping the doctor with the wiring, she then asks him, dying from what?
The first doctor, you know I don't know. I don't think their scientists knew either, they started replacing their bodies with spare parts in way to survive, but that came with a price which as you know they have no emotions. They want us to become like them, their faces are covered with like a cloth.
Alex King, that sounds like the ones we seeing in the other room, that almost attacked us, well almost if Captain Jack's vortex manipulator didn't work.
Lucky it did, we were almost goners.
The first doctor, almost done and fixed, I think it's ready to go, Kate would you boot up the computer and see what happens?
I hope it works some.
Alex King, yeah, me too doctor.
The problem solved.
The computer mainframe boots up. Then it loads up and a screen comes up saying he is awake. Kate Stewart looks funny at the message.
Alex King, what's wrong mom?
Kate Stewart, I'm not sure, some weird message.
The first doctor, must being a computer error, or what was left of the glitching.
Kate Stewart, maybe you're right doctor.
The first doctor, now it's all booted up, we can find your doctor, or myself, well my future me, I think I'm getting that headache that Alex got.
Alex King, laughs, puts his hand on the first doctor's shoulders, you are the best doctor, you know that, but the best is yet to come, I bet.
The best is yet to come.
Kate Stewart, oh, we found him, the doctor he in the next room, oh this isn't going to be easy to get to him.
Captain Jack, it never is.
Elizabeth Snowden, let me guess, Cybermen?
Computer tells Kate Stewart what Cybermen they are.
Kate Stewart, it's worse than just Cybermen, we never get to the doctor with Mondasian Cybermen guarding him, gold bullets are not going to work, we are sitting ducks.
The first doctor, I know normal bullets don't work, but how you know these gold bullets you speak of don't work?
Elizabeth Snowden, the lady from wherever she is.
We not worked out who she is, and why, and how the doctor is here.
But then again, I like to know how she got the past version of the doctor here, meaning you?
Kate Stewart, that is good question, we all sure like to find out.
The first doctor, you ever tried to shoot the Cybermen and aim at their heads, that could be their weak point, notice how they have cloth over their faces, it's not much of a shield like the others seems to have.
I know people tried using normal bullets on them.
But maybe your gold bullet could work if you aim them right.
Alex King, I am not sure guns are going to work just yet, do you know how many Cybermen are guarding our doctor mom?
Kate Stewart, well, I can check on this computer, it might help us.
Kate Stewart checks the computer mainframe, the computer is picking up at least 5 Cybermen guarding the doctor.
The first doctor, what we must do, we can't just walk in there, we will be sitting ducks without some weapons.
Alex King, the doctor is right, we need to lure some of the Cybermen out here, somehow.
Captain Jack, I wonder why they didn't come out here in first place beforehand?
The first doctor, maybe they don't know we are here.
Elizabeth Snowden, can we just be grateful they didn't come out here?
The Cybermen plan of action.
Kate Stewart, that's because the doors are sealed shut, I will find a way to open it but, we must come up with a plan.
Walks to the remains of the Cybermen and picks up one of the hands of them, then looks at the gun have a weapon on their hands.
I have an idea, what if use these weapons against them?
We might need our gun still though.
The first doctor, that's a good idea.
Alex King, we could go in hiding, we could hide behind these pods, they may not see us.
Captain Jack, me and Alex could get to the doors without them seeing us somehow.
Kate Stewart, yes, that sound good, but be careful, once I hacked into the computer to open the doors, the plan of ours starts from then on, there be no looking back.
Alex King, yes mom.
Kate Stewart hacks into the computer's mainframe to open the doors, the unit team hide behind the matrix pods, as planned, giving time for Kate Stewart to go and hide out too.
Alex King and Elizabeth Snowden lure 2 Cybermen out of the room that the doctor is in, which is the main matrix room.
Kate Stewart uses the weapons of the Cybermen against the Mondasian Cybermen.
Now there are only 3 more to take down, and they be waiting this time around for the team to get in the room the doctor is in.
The Cybermen know about the unit team this time and are here to save the doctor, they weapon up and ready, and now armed with their weapons.
K
Captain Jack, the doors reopen and everyone is ready to take down the Cybermen, but the unit team are hidden behind the Matrix pods. The two Mondasian Cybermen walk out of the main Matrix room the Doctor is in and see no one there. But that's what they think until the unit team sees a chance to attack the Mondasian Cybermen. The last Cybermen see them, they try to attack them back, they fail to do. So Alex King and Captain Jack sneak down near the doors of the main Matrix room doors. Both Captain Jack and Alex King hit behind of the Mondasian Cybermen, and they both shot it down just like that. Safe for now. Alex King, it okay now, we can now enter and get the Doctor out of the Matrix. The unit team and the first Doctor enter the room, the doors close. As the unit team leave the Matrix pod room, the computer's mainframe comes up with the same message from before, saying he is awake on a blink. Meanwhile, the unit team are now looking around main Matrix room and see the Doctor in the pod. Alex King and Captain Jack try to open it, but then Kate Stewart and Elizabeth Snowden spot same kind of computer in this room, but it seems different than the other computer. It seems bigger and a TV screen above it. The Matrix pod doesn't open the doors like the other one in the Matrix pod room, not like in the last room did. Then they all hear a voice, a woman's voice. Alex King, who is that? Who is there? River Song slash the Watcher appears out of nowhere. Don't be alarmed, I am the Watcher, the Doctor's subconscious mind. I can help you with that computer. I can talk you through it. I can take someone into the Matrix. That is why there is another pod next to it. Elizabeth Snowden, how come you can't do that? I mean, use it. River Song slash the Watcher, I am the Doctor's subconscious mind. I can't touch anything. River Song slash the Watcher looks at the first Doctor. I remember being you. You're the first me, the original me. Oh, Elizabeth, thank you for missing that Cyberman and hitting computer's mainframe. You did the Doctor a favor. Elizabeth Snowden, what you mean? River Song slash the Watcher, the computer mainframe was censoring me. The Watcher is like a warning and a guide to a possible regeneration. I'm a subconscious part of the Doctor's mind. When you missed your shot it and all, that when the computer's mainframe started glitching. The part of the program stopped censoring part of the Doctor's mind. That's when it allowed the subconscious mind to warn itself. That way the Doctor's mind will slowly open up. That's if the Doctor will listen to me. The subconscious mind of the Doctor can reflect outside of his mind to see what's going on. But he can only see in there. Only pond in the Doctor's mind is the river. Alex King, was anyone following that? Captain Jack, how do we get the Doctor out the Matrix pod? River Song slash the Watcher, that you can't in this room. There are things I've heard in this room, and the lady you heard earlier is Madame Kovarian. I don't know what she done with our mind. Something is missing, but I can't seem to see what's wrong until one of you go in and wake him up. Captain Jack, I will do it that if you be there. River Song slash the Watcher, I can only reflect outside of his subconscious mind. I did say Jack, he only can see me inside the Matrix. I already tried to tell him. I did try to show him the real world, but it has been hard to do. So, you be on your own. Once he sees someone he recognizes that might trigger his memories into waking himself up. Alex King and Elizabeth Snowden help Captain Jack to set up in the Matrix pod. The Master is awake. The computer's Matrix mainframe is still flicking with a sign saying he is awake. The Master is awake, but then sees a Mondasian Cyberman get up from the main doors of the Matrix room. The Mondasian Cyberman isn't quite dead. The Master walks out of the Matrix pod, then falls over down on his knees. The Master feels weak. His body felt like it was still asleep. The Master, he sees light come on in a yellow Matrix pod. The Master gets up and walks to it. The Master tried to open it to see what's in it. The Master, what the hell is going on here? The Master tried to open the doors, but they are sealed closed. The unit team locked the doors on the inside. So, the Master is stopped by the Cyberman. The doors of the yellow pod opens up, but the strange man is not awake yet. The Cyberman walks up to the Master. He will have no choice but to help the Cyberman. Cyber Bill, you will help me, please help me. The Master, why would I do that? You're a Cyberman. Cyber Bill, my name is Bill Potts, and you must help me. The Master, maybe I could use this to hack this computer to find what is going on here. the master sees the two versions of the doctor in the main matrix room on the computer. The doctor is in matrix pod, then who is? Oh, no way. Cyber Bill, what is wrong?
The master, nothing, it's just that the doctor original self is here too, but why though?
The master tries to hack into the computer mainframe of the matrix pod room. The master finally unlocks the doors, but he sees the doctor is in the next room and other life signs in the next room, so he helps the Cyberman that seemed to be more human for some reason. The master opens the doors at last, walks in. The master sees the doctor and smiles, and then Cyber Bill walks in too.
The master, doctor isn't awake yet.
Alex King about to shoot at the Cyberman down and the master.
The master, don't shoot this Cyberman, it seems different somehow, don't shoot me either.
Alex King, want me to shoot the master, then we could ask questions to the Cyberman after?
Kate Stewart, no, the doctor would want him alive, besides the doctor would never forgive us.
The master, I guess you're stuck with me as I am to help.
A stranger's identity.
The strange man walks out of the yellow pod and in a deep voice, where am I?
Madame Kovarian beams up the strange man to the overview room, she greets the him.
Madame Kovarian, hello doctor, you ready for a war?
The strange man, I am never going to be a part of the doctor's regeneration cycles anymore, that's too bad, I was looking forward to that, but never mind, let's take the doctor down, war is my game.
Captain Jack and the doctor.
The doctor, well, are you going to tell me how you got here, Jack?
Captain Jack, doctor, you are in the Matrix, they have you locked up on a Cyberman ship, then there's some woman named Madame Kovarian, she behind all this setup.
The doctor, Madame Kovarian, I must stop her, Jack, there one thing was you here before in this mad world.
Captain Jack, know why?
The doctor, they must have programmed a copy of you in here from my memories.
Captain Jack helps to wake the doctor up from the Matrix. The doctor is now awake, and will be out of the Matrix, trouble is ahead.
The doctor is awake and the long song.
The doctor steps out of the Matrix pod, something is missing, something seems different, the doctor falls to the floor, looks at his first original self.
The first doctor, why are you looking at me like that for, hum?
The doctor stands up, I feel like I am missing something, am I a good man?
The doctor remembers Wilfred Mott answering that question, my head, what is wrong with me, my head, why are you here, I am the doctor.
The first doctor, you might be a doctor, but I am the original, you might say.
The longest game.
Madame Kovarian planned to use the Cybermen to get to the doctor's mind to get this man extracted from him, but because of her the Cybermen know how to convert Time Lord slash ladies into Cybermen, that information must be stopped by the doctor and the unit team.
Madame Kovarian lead the Cybermen ship use a time warp and the Cybership will follow her ship, as part of the deal she has with them. She gets in on a ship with the strange man away from the doctor.
Madame Kovarian used the Cybermen technology to get the strange man extracted out from the doctor. It was her to set up a new war against the doctor, but will she be a target of the Cybermen now if she doesn't come through with her deal with them?
The Vieillard.
Madame Kovarian, so, are you the Vieillard I hope to have then?
The Vieillard, what do you want with me?
Why did you call me doctor?
Madame Kovarian, to take my revenge on the doctor this time, I will win, good will win.
The Vieillard, too bad, I will never be part of the doctor, we will wait until the doctor finds us, he will eventually, bad wolf is coming.